we've implicitly assumed that your outcome only depends on your own treatment status. It doesn't depend on the treatment status of other people out there who are around you, okay? For example, think about Perry Preschool. Well, suppose we've got two neighbors, two kids that live right next door to each other. One of the kids was randomly assigned to get preschool, and the other kid was randomly assigned to not get preschool. Well, suppose these kids, they're neighbors, they're friends, they play together. So the kid who goes to preschool may talk with his neighbor and tell him things that he learned in preschool. And that may have an effect on the outcomes of his neighbor. Okay, this is a kid who was not in the treatment group, who did not get assigned to preschool, and yet he's being affected by the treatment indirectly through his neighbor. That's called a spillover effect or a social interaction. Now that is a problem for analyzing experiments. It makes things very, very complicated. And in these modules, we're basically going to skip this problem and assume that there are no spillovers or nothing like this is going on in practice. Now that's often called a no interference assumption or the stable unit treatment value assumption, or SUPA, okay? But basically it means that only your own treatment status affects your outcome. Okay, and that's an assumption we're going to have to make in doing lots of our analysis. Now, relaxing that assumption is something that's very near and dear to my heart because it's what I work on in my own research, but things are going to get really complicated. So for now, let's just focus on the simple case where we assume there are no spillovers.